Oh, man. He's huge. Bigger than anything I've ever seen in my whole life.
You have collected all 7 Dragon Balls.
Chaos only used the negative power of the emeralds. Sonic, you should be able to harness their real power!
As much as I hate to admit it, I think Tails is right about this.
Go, Sonic! Yeah, Sonic!
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 Negative forces aren't the only way to empower the Chaos Emeralds! Our positive feelings toward each other can make them work! Our hearts together form awesome power!
Thank you.
When the Titanic left, it was declared the unsinkable ship. If you do that, Allah will sink it, just to spite it. You can't do that. When they made the Challenger, now you know what Challenger mean in Arabic? Mutahaddi. It's a very bad word. Who are they challenging? They're sending it off into space. Who are you challenging? Challenging who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Well, look what happened. He'll just blow you up. That's what Allah will do. Literally just blow you up. And then they say, oh, it's a tragedy. The seventh grade teacher riding on raw technology. They put a seventh grade teacher into raw technology, thinking that they're qadirin alayha, hatta dhanna ahluha annahum qadirun alayha. They thought the people, they'll become so deluded, Allah says in Surah Yunus, they will become so deluded that they think they're all powerful over the earth. Right? So they take off on the Challenger. Allah, you want to call it Challenger? We'll see how long the challenge lasts.
So as we start to look into the numerology, what we're looking at is a tree of life. And this is something that the magicians use, and what I believe to be a map of the extra dimension. So as you're looking into this map, there are 10 spots on it, and they are called the Sephiroth. And within these Sephiroths, you have your Trinity at the top. So this is the All, the One, looking at itself and creating a reflection. It's the 1, 2, 3, and that's why 1, 2, and 3 are all still one. And then 4 is the first emanation into reality. And then we come down where 6 becomes Jesus. And as we're looking at this numerology, you go up from the bottom up to the top. You have 10 points. 10 being God. 10 being the hermaphroditic symbol. 1 and 0. And you're going to find these constant hermaphroditic symbols, Hermes and Aphrodite. You'll constantly find these everywhere. That's what the target sun sign is. It's the hermaphroditic symbol. That's what the compass and square is. They're sexual symbols. The point within the circle is a hermaphroditic symbol. So as you come up to 10, that is their God. That is 10. That is the hermaphrodite. But if you stop at 9 and you skip to 11, skipping God, then you are a Luciferian. Because 11 is the number of the magician. It's the one step above. Once you have accomplished the tree of life, you are now the magician. You are one above 10. But they're doing it by skipping God. That's the symbolism of 9-11.